Welcome to today's Eliminator. I am back from holiday, and I have been busy racing. I have won the Eliminator 10 times today, and yesterday, and the day before. I have decided only to bring you the best games. This is the best games from today's racing. I have not included the first race as it was a standard, uneventful final win in my GTR versus a Centenario. So let's go racing. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. I will keep the uneventful stuff to a minimum so you don't have to fast forward. That Camaro has become a Group A, and I believe it is going to chase me. I just know it. Blimmin' Griefer. I am up against it enough without Griefers wrecking my race. Griefers suck. They are right up there with cheaters. If I get past this race, I am coming after that Griefer. What's a Griefer? It's a spoiler. A person who purposely wrecks another racer's game. There are a few Griefers on my radar, and I am always on the lookout to punish them. My opponent just got taken out by that Centenario. That gives me breathing space to win. To be fair, the GTR might have been turning, and it was an accident. But I am taking it personally, as I am striking too many of them. Sorry, buddy, I know you were taken out too. Right, let's go find that GTR. There it is, let's cause them some grief. Payback. The other day I was caused to lose by a griefer who just banged and knocked my Nomad constantly until I was beaten. They had nothing to do with our race, they just aimed to cause grief. I would have won easily but ended up losing. That is why I hate them.
Arena shrinking!
I am not very good at griefing. I keep missing them. The arena is shrinking. I better get back for the final. A quick hello, and then I better get on it. I am not sure I can make it back in time for the start of the race. So where is the Centenario? This is why this car is not a level 10. It's quite skitterish and bounces around too much. However, that will close up the race as it was a bit one-sided. I have a couple of really good finals coming up. Three in a row that need perfect jumps to win. Well, Pennywise, karma gotcha. Griefing didn't help you win. Debt settled.
Welcome to the secret society of the Illuminati!
Oh.
Game one was played just after midnight. This is now the next day, and guess what? It's Friday for me and Thursday for the rest of the world. That can only mean one thing. The Forza season has changed, and the lake is back in. I love it when the lake is in. That Murcielago is slow off-road, as it needs time to wind up. I might just have this if it can't get a chance to build speed. Come on, little Maserati. Don't let it catch you. Whoa. I have had so many close races over the last 3 days. That was so close. Game 3. It's actually game 4, as I just won the last game in my level 9 VW, but forgot to record it. I had to go off-road against the highway runners. My main competition was Gamertag Tree Hill, and guess what? They are the car behind me in this race too. The main competition is a level 10 Brocky. There is something fast coming to my left. It's just past me, and bang, it's crashed. The Brocky has gone that way. I just seen it dart across the road. 3 different paths, who will win? This way is the fastest. I have to navigate trees and a bridge though, and it's nighttime. Oops, the bridge. I am meant to be more to the right. I could be in trouble here. Another close finish. And this time we switched positions. Well played. I will do better next time and navigate the bridge better. Game 4 is really just a standard game. It is all about a Funko versus this Brocky. I totally had my timings messed up there. I started a long way back but had to brake lest I self-eliminate. Whoa, that rock was too close for comfort. Note to self. Some games are a little boring to race. This one seems like that to me. However, the finals coming up are excellent and had me laughing and buzzing.
Welcome to the shadowy ranks of the Illuminati.
Game 5 has some very good players in it. No, I didn't want to meet Terwindos in the head-to-head, and I will eliminate him as my car is better than his. That's a shame, a big disappointment. Well, that is one A-grade player gone. Hopefully the final is good. That Murcielago turned into a level 9 VW, and now this RS200. It's time for the final. We are up against some fast level 10s and some rubbish cars, too.
Head-to-head's complete. Get ready for the final showdown. Final showdown begins in 30 seconds.
I should have been gone, but distracted by all these cars. Oops.
Final showdown in 3, 2, 1, go!
This is the first day the lake has been in for 2 weeks, and many will forget that. Nice. I have always wanted to do this. I put a video out called The Biggest Fail in 7,500 Games. This is going to readdress that fail. I would normally go off here to the left and jump the hill and cross the bridge, but I have decided to keep going this way. That was awesome.
Winner! Welcome to the Illuminati!
No, it's not a glitch. It's a jump you can learn, and it's no different than jumping off a cliff or over buildings and streets in the city. Game 6. I have stopped eliminating people as I want good cars for the final. There is an AMG 1 and a Centenario out there. This AMG 1 has been chasing me all over the place, wanting to eliminate me. But I want to race it in the final. I am not afraid of it, as this RS200 and the Brocky are by far the best eliminating cars for short, punchy head-to-heads. I could easily set them up and eliminate them, but that would mean a boring final.
Arena shrinking!
I only have to play this silly game of cat and mouse for a few seconds more. Away you go. Good luck. You don't need to do this. Don't wreck your final, and mine. At least another Centenario has joined us. I hope you are speaking to yourself to prepare as you never prepared. And now you are going to lose.
Final showdown in 3, 2, 1, go!
Mind the rock. That rock has caught me out too many times. I didn't know there was a bump there. Another note to self.
Please congratulate the Eliminator!
Game 7. I am up against a Centenario and a Brocky. I have played 9,750 games, and I have never had the fail I am about to have. To be fair, I was talking to the neighbor who was standing beside me about how to play the Eliminator, and my 3-year-old boy is jumping all over me, distracting me. Looks close to the sports arena, so I might take the road. In the distraction around me, I mistake a flagpole for, you guessed it, the finish pin. It lines up almost perfectly with the pin and makes me think I have crossed the line and won. I am like those runners who celebrate a lap early thinking they have finished. Right there, I think it's over and I won. I was looking to see if the Brocky or Centenario was second. I don't really care, it was just funny. That's what distraction will do for you. Game 8. I am still highly distracted by people and I make another fail. I am following these tracks to my start point by this lamppost, however I don't realize it's the wrong tracks. And the wrong lamppost. How I survived that I don't know. Now I have maximum arena damage, and I have to go after the announcer calls the word go, or I will self-eliminate. Even if I go on the word go, it will kill me. I must be after.
Final showdown in 3, 2, 1, go!
That is crazy. You can't shoot the starter gun and then penalize the runners because they started. Game 9. This looks like an upgrade trap. I am up against rubbish cars, and there is a good chance someone will successfully manipulate this. It's totally split, two going that way, two going this. That level two, RS6 might get the manipulation. Oops, is it just me? Or does that silly map confuse you too? With left being right, and right being left. Why can't they just do what every other GPS does, and rotate with you? This is awesome. This final was going to be terrible, boring, and non-eventful. Thank you for manipulating it, RS6. If I turned and headed down the highway to the RS6's start point, it would have taken me a minute. So on the highway, they have a minute's head start. I will go the direct route. It's a long race, so I can only assume it's in the canyon. Which way have they gone, as I am still coming second last? This manipulation makes it anyone's win. That's what I love about it. That lake jump is no different to this jump. It's equally fair. Someone called me a cheat because I jumped the lake. Well, I jump over houses and streets too, and off cliffs. It's all part of the game.
Welcome to the secret society of the Illuminati!
Oh, shh. Game 10 was a gift. I give away wins every session. Game 11 is the last game, and it's another fun one. Oops, trouble. Can I sneak away? Nope. Okay, let's do it then. That's a nice upgrade. Now for the final showdown. I think there is a Funko out there.
Final showdown in 3, 2, 1.
Whoa, and an AMG 1, where did that come from? It's on the other side of the lake. Who out of these racers remembers the lake is in today? Looks like none of them. Epic fails. That was fun. To them, they might have thought I teleported. Nope, I jumped.
Congratulations!
Hey, where is my eliminator screen?
You are the eliminator.
Well, that was today's racing. Thanks for watching. I had a few more, but I wanted to keep this video short as possible. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope to see you in the arena soon.